Okay, so let us start today about the diversity in the living world. So whenever we are thinking about the diversity in the living world, then we have to think for the nomenclature. Actually, in case of nomenclature, that means naming of a particular living thing, we have to think. Because whenever we are going in different places of the earth or even in India, then different places the name of one organism is different. So Carolus Linnaeus first of all given the process of binomial nomenclature. So nomenclature, that is, it is also called scientific nomenclature. So binomial nomenclature, he has given the two names, one is a genus, another is the species. So one living thing has two parts, genus and species. For example, human being is Homo sapiens. Homo sapiens, S-A-P-I-E-N-S, sapiens. So here Homo is the genus and species, and sapiens is the species. Like way, mango, Mangifera indica. So like this, scientific names he has propounded. Then ICBN and ICZN are the two organizations, they have pointed out and cited some rules for this in scientific nomenclature. So ICBN, that is the International Code for Botanical Nomenclature. International Code for Botanical Nomenclature and ICZN are the International Code for Zoological Nomenclature. These are the two organizations. Other organizations are also there, like ICVN, that means International Code for Viral Nomenclature. So they have given, cited some rules for naming of the species, that is genus and species. So first of all, that is, first one is genus, like Mangifera indica. So first name, this is the name, scientific name of mango. So first name must start with a capital letter. That is, genus must start with capital letter, species must start with a small letter. This is the first rule. Second rule means, other so many rules are there, some important rules I am telling. That is, both of them must be underlined, and underlined in separately, not in the same line. Then the priority, that is the first name who has given, that one will be the taken as the prior nomenclature. Next, that is the whenever he has given, whenever the ICBN and ICZN, they have given the rules, then if it is printed, then if italics numerals and italics, that is alphabets, are written, then no need for giving the underlines. Now I have written something about the taxonomic hierarchy in ascending order. So this is category and this is taxon. So in the category, highest form is the kingdom, then phylum or division, then class, then order, then family, then genus, and then species. So some species together has similar properties. Whenever a number of species has a similar properties, these species, they will form a genus. Some species, they will form a genus. So sapiens, erectus, like Homo sapiens, Homo erectus, Homo neanderthalensis, like these different species of human being are there. We are Homo sapiens. So some species together forming one genus. Again, some genus, same thing, some genus, they will form a family, like hominidae. Hominidae is a family where a number of genus are there. Next is the, when is the order? Order means the primata. So in primata, that is in primata, there is some family together forming the primata groups. And in mammalia, again, is a class is mammalia. Mammalia has different orders like primata, monotremata, then carnivora, like this carnivora, that is who are taking only flesh, like this. These are the a number of orders together forming the mammalia. Again, mammalia is a class. Some classes together forming the phylum Chordata. Phylum Chordata, that is the organisms which possess chordate characters. Chordate means has the backbone. And all chordates, non-chordates, vertebrates, invertebrates together forming the taxon Animalia.